When he spoke at Davos this year, Sir David Attenborough mentioned something you might have missed.
There will be United Nations decisions on climate change, sustainable development, and a new deal for nature.
Humans are now destroying wildlife at such a rate that many scientists believe the Earth is experiencing a sixth mass extinction event. They warn that this is not just a threat to nature and all its wonder, but to us. Some scientists now say the destruction of nature is as big a threat to humanity as climate change. But we're talking about it far less. Three times less, in fact, according to a 15-year analysis of biodiversity and climate change coverage in the media.
From my perspective, loss of biodiversity and the degradation of nature is equally important as human-induced climate change. We all know human-induced climate change will affect food security, water security, human health. So will loss of biodiversity.
That's Sir Bob Watson, and he would know. 20 years ago, he was head of the IPCC, the global scientific body that advises governments on climate change. Now he chairs ITBES, the equivalent body for biodiversity, which is essentially the variety of all life on Earth.
We humans are deforesting the forests of the world. We're converting the mangrove swamps. We're polluting the coral reefs. We're polluting our rivers. There is no question we humans are affecting both biodiversity and climate change. None at all.
If this is such a crisis then, why don't we hear much about it?
I'm George Monbiot. I've been an environmental journalist for 33 years. And during that time, there has never been a good moment to talk about ecological destruction. What I perceive in public opinion is a great appetite to discover what's happening to the only planet which supports life and what's happening to our life support systems on this planet. What I perceive within the media is a great appetite not to know anything about it.
Media coverage may be slim, but environmentalists are now turning their eyes towards two global deals. First up, over the next year, a new UN deal on the high seas, the two-thirds of the oceans that fall outside of national laws. And at the end of 2020, a global summit in China, where world leaders hope to agree new targets for nature that some have compared to the Paris climate change deal. Before then, some are trying to translate this crisis into something those Davos delegates might understand. Money. The world's wetlands, for example, beneficial as flood protection and carbon storage, have been valued in their billions. Numbers like that could be useful for convincing politicians to act. But of course, nature is about more than money. Professor Sebsebi Demesiu is based at the University of Addis Ababa and has been documenting plants across Africa for decades.
You can't value nature in monetary way, it's just to really explain to people. But nature's contribution is more than that. How would you value your happiness in the forest? Your spiritual value, you go to the forest, you worship that forest. How would you calculate that in terms of monetary value?
Whoever you are, whether you live in a forest or a high rise, we all depend on nature. For food, clean air and water, good health, mental well-being, and a sense of identity and community. What we're learning is that much of that is now at risk. This is Life Support, a series about why the global nature crisis matters for our lives.
In the rest of the Life Support series, we look at how bugs put food on the table, coral reefs save lives, and tiny shrimp-like creatures in Antarctica are an ally in the fight to stop climate breakdown. So make sure you're subscribed, check out the other videos in this series, and if you think this is something more people should know about, share it with your friends.